My name is Kenny Creasy. I was born and raised in Westmoreland, Tennessee. Didn't like to study, worked on the farm. We used to milk about 35, 36 head of cows. Anything that's got anything to do with sports, I loved it. What I did right out of high school, I started in Drones Business College. I didn't like school, so I quit. She called me and told me, she said, Kenny, you're gonna get drafted. She said, you're about the fifth or sixth one left on the list. What I did, I went down to Nashville and two of my friends, Kenneth Trout and William Spears, they were gonna go with me. So they let me go in first and I joined the Air Force. And they both got up and walked out and laughed. They didn't join nothing. When I first started out, I was the last group to take our basic training in Amarillo, Texas.
Here I welcome you to basic military training, United States Air Force. During the next 6 weeks, 42 calendar days, 30 training days, you'll be transitioning from civilian to the military.
And I'll never forget it. When I got off of the bus to do my training, it was snowing around Amarillo, and it was colder than the dickens, and I did my basic in Amarillo. Then I was transferred to do my tech training at Chanute Air Force Base in Illinois. When I got done there, I was stationed back to Randolph Air Force Base in San Antonio, Texas. After I left Randolph Air Force Base, I was stationed in Misawa Air Force Base, Japan. Learned how to snow ski, did a lot of snow skiing. I would go TDY, temporary duty assignment. And what we would do, we'd stay 30 days at different places. And they had two bases in Korea. One of them was Daegu Air Force Base, and the other one was Kunsan Air Force Base.
This is the McDonnell Phantom II, a powerful and steadily growing force for the defense of the free world.
We had two F-4 Phantoms sitting on the pads, and they had nuclear weapons on them. And that's all we do for 30 days is just sit there and watch that in case something happened. What I had to do before the plane could ever leave the ground, I had to arm the system, the seat and the canopy before they took off. And when they come back, I have to de-arm the seat and the canopy.
Force-deployed parachutes and automatically deployed survival kits are just some of the improvements which were designed to facilitate crew members' escape.
I spent about 3 months, 3.5 months there, and they gave me an early out. And then after I got out, I come back to Tennessee. I had five wonderful kids. Sean, he hung around. He loved to do things with us. He liked to ride horses. He liked the mechanic. Shane, the second one, he didn't like the mechanic, but he wanted to do more things like management and stuff like that, and that's what he got into. And then there's Kendra. She was my oldest daughter, and Kyla was a little feisty, and Kristen was probably maybe not the easiest, but, you know, they wasn't as high strung as the rest of them. I've always loved mechanicing from day one. I loved the mechanic. I loved the challenge of trying to fix something, and I wanted to do what I loved doing. I think the intentions that we had was exactly what we did in 1989. I bought my own business.